Welcome back. This is Prep Recruiting Insider, PRI, here at Moe's Pizza on the West Bank. I'm your head coach for PRI, Rick Daly, along with our Prep Recruiting Insider, the man, the legend, Rene Nato. We appreciate you being here with us this evening and being here with these two terrific Shaw Eagle athletes. To your right, offensive tackle Cameron Jackel, and to your left, defensive back Greg Brooks. Thank you, gentlemen, for being here with us today on PRI.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for having me.
Cameron, I'm going to start with you. And you made a big decision, decided you want to be a Tulane Green Wave. I want to ask you, why is Tulane a good fit for you, and what other schools did you consider?
Tulane, I'm going to start with that. It was a good fit for me because it has a really, really high academic standard, and it's a very well-coached football team in the past, and then now with Coach Willie Fritz, I have a lot of faith in them. Other schools I was looking at, I was thinking maybe Louisiana Tech because of the engineering program. I wanted to be an electrical engineer. Mm-hmm. And then at one point I was talking to Arkansas, you know, so it's a couple of nice schools, you know, outside of the city. But after Tulane came to me, I really decided, you know, this is where I want to be.
Is the process over?
Yes, sir. Now that I'm committed, I'm standing by my decision. It's pretty much over, yes.
Greg, you're only a sophomore, but, you know, a lot of good things have been said about you, and you are kind of watching the recruiting process, and you've had some schools, LSU, Florida State, Clemson, USC, watching you. How much are you really, are you interested in getting this process over soon, or you want to go to signing date, or what are you looking for in the school? What's going to like to come up to you?
First of all, I'm going to start off getting the process over with, probably signing day of 2019.
Okay.
And probably this type of school I'm looking for, education, playing time, of course, and lifestyle. Basically.
Okay.
Cameron, you've always been on the left side.
Yes, sir.
Been a left tackle the whole time, and I would guess you would anticipate in college playing the same position.
Yes, sir, I do.
Talk about in being a Shaw Eagle offensive tackle, you've had to be pretty versatile. They've been a running team at times, a throwing team at times, and now in a transition trying to gain an identity. Talk about the versatility that you have at the offensive tackle position.
Well, I mean, I've been playing offensive line. Of course, I was big as a child, so they started me out when I was like 5 years old playing offensive line, so I've never really moved. But in the past couple of years at Shaw, they've moved me to tight end every now and then. We'll call a certain play and have me out at tight end because I'm pretty quick on the outside. I've got a lot of good footwork, so I can get outside and seal off that edge and let the running back or the quarterback get out. So, you know, it's nice that they trust me enough to do both sides. And then left tackle, it really started out as kind of like whatever. But after I started playing, I realized that with a right-handed quarterback, I got to have his back. So it's really a humbling experience, you know. And you got to have good footwork, good concentration, you know, calling out defenses, you know, audibling, whatever, to the offensive line, telling them which way to set the front. So it's a nice experience.
You can't take a playoff.
No, sir.
And it's interesting to see what the other side looks like sometimes, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
That's very good. Greg? Talk about your versatility. You don't just play corner, you play safety as well. Talk about the versatility that you have in the secondary.
Yes, sir, I play corner and safety, as you said. Playing corner is all about having good footwork, keep your feet moving, stuff like that. Safety, when I get at safety, just helping the run game a lot, never get nothing past me.
Greg, your dad, former Shaw Eagle, played at Southern Mississippi, and then he spent 3 years in the NFL with the Cincinnati Bengals. He left Southern Miss as the all-time leader in pass breakups with 47. How much of his game have you adopted in your skill set?
A lot. He helps me a lot. Like, after every single game, he grades me on off of film and stuff like that. It just helps me a lot. I think that's where I get all my athletic ability from. But all in all, I just want to be better than him.
I mean, he played with Carson Palmer and Ocho Cinco and those guys, and so he played with some really, really good players. Cameron, we had you on last year, and how do you feel like you've improved as a tackle now that you're getting ready for college, and what areas did you work on and you saw results?
I really was working on strength most of all, because that's really the basis of offensive line. You got to have a strong base, good feet, you know, strong, you have high squat weight to be able to hold them back, you know, and then I lost my train of thought.
what areas did you where have you worked on?
I was working a lot of footwork. Like my brother helped me work out, and we would go out to the gym, get a lift, and then afterwards we'd go outside, do some sprints, do ladder drills, cones, you know, a lot of footwork-based stuff. And I even considered playing basketball because everyone I've spoken to has said that playing two sports really helps with your versatility.
Absolutely, and your cross-training is is absolutely invaluable. Did you have somebody that was a player or perhaps a team that you thought of as your favorite, or especially did you have a player that you patterned your game after Cameron?
Not really. I've never, you know, nobody, my uncles, two of my uncles played for Shaw. One was a receiver, one was a kicker. But my dad rode motocross in high school. He came to Shaw. So I never really had somebody in my family that was I was modeled after. And I never watched football as a kid. I was always outside playing the game. So, no, I haven't really modeled anything after anybody. But now I'm starting to look, like whenever I watch football now, I'll watch the left tackle, see what they're doing, how, what I can adapt to my playing style.
And Greg, besides your father, isn't it amazing? You know, he didn't have somebody looking at his film when he was in when he was at Shaw critique if it wasn't available like that. But besides your father, is there somebody who plays defensive back that you like to watch? Maybe you've patterned again, but you particularly like to watch?
Really, I like to watch Tyrann Mathieu for the Arizona Cardinals. Yeah, I like his game a lot because he's small like me, not that big.
And he's tough and goes 1,000 miles an hour. Like we talk about with Cameron, you can't take a play off. You just keep going and going and going. That's what makes a winner. That's two terrific Shaw athletes. Look right over there at the red light, fellas. Give them your best look because this is what they're going to remember. That's Cameron Jackel and Greg Brooks. We appreciate them being here today from Archbishop Shaw. When we come right back, more great information you can't find anywhere else. This is PRI.